needs finding, you first go and do an observational phase where you, you know, clear your mind of all prejudices, go out there, see how care is provided. That's the first step. You go back home, look at your observations, which are basically just literally, I saw this doctor do that, and then that was done. And try to extract, why was it being done that way? Could it be done better? Is there some obvious problem, or were the people fretting about something? Is that, you know, pain points being identified? That's the next step. You extract your needs from that observation.
We were taught in class to basically have the three components and the need statement and basically follow that way, how to do it. Having a way to do something better with outcome and a patient population. So having that framework just made it much easier.
In a need statement, you have your problem, you have your population, and you have your outcome. Usually the problem is fairly clear. That usually is settled pretty early. It's the population, and most of the time it's the outcome, because a lot of the times you will not see a negative outcome in the observations. You sometimes have to intuit that, and sometimes you have to verify with the doctors that, you know, you were doing it like this, what would happen if you don't do it like this? And that's something which is very tough, the outcome part.
I think regarding the problems, sometimes we are not sure. Some people think, for example, confusion is a state of mind, which I may think that I saw someone was confused, you may think that they were not confused. And when you go and ask them, they would definitely say, we were not confused, we are so proficient at it. So these kind of things which you have to judge and you have to make a call, sometimes make it a little difficult. The fact that you have a limited number of observations also stresses you on the front that maybe it's just a one-time thing that you saw, and it's not a continuum of problem that's going to happen.
What we did is we all sat together and thought of the problem as such and formed a sentence, and it took almost like 3 to 4 sessions to get the exact statement which fits the exact observation as such, because most of the statements we came up, we realized that it doesn't have the most important parts, like what exactly are you trying to solve and who is it going to benefit. So this was something which requires a bit of experience.
The only challenge would be if we all, like multiple people, saw one observation or one kind of procedure and multiple observations within a procedure, and what was the most important thing, what did we want to capture in the need statement. So those took the longest to get through. I wouldn't say there was conflict, it was just like a lot of work to, we would put all of them up on the whiteboard and then try to figure out what was the most important piece of all of that, and then write. Sometimes we wrote, you know, 5 need statements for it, and sometimes we got down to just 1. So that was a little bit of an art and not a science, so it's a little challenging.
The way we saw the observation was different. Like my friend who was an engineer, he saw it in a different viewpoint. Whereas for me, as a doctor, I know that these are the restrictions. My observations were completely different.
Basically, you try not to include solutions in the need statements. So this has sometimes become really tricky to how to identify a problem without thinking of a solution.
I think that when you're an innovator, you automatically try to come up with a million solutions. But the process of biodesign teaches that first you have to focus on a really good need statement and go from there.
So the process of converting observations into needs was probably a little challenging at first, but after you do a couple days of it, it becomes like you just speak in need statements.